A very good evening and welcome to the Newsroom. My name is Joshua Pora and this is TNR Celebrity Edition. Now my guest for tonight is...
Bobi Wine, aka the Ghetto President.
Well, let's have a look at the story that are making headlines in our newscast tonight.
Police to reduce traffic on highways.
Government to set up Skills Development Authority.
5 in custody over Kenya University attack.
Co-pilot acted deliberately in German wings crash. Well, now let's have a look at the news in detail. Police is going to create road diversions to reduce the high security risk and the unending jam along highways in the country. The Inspector General of Police, General Kale Kahura, says traffic jams caused along the highway roads is a target for the Al-Shabaab, which calls for the public cooperation.
Jinja Highway, Entebbe Highway are some of the many highways where heavy traffic jam build up. The Inspector General of Police has noticed these highways as high security risk places. So as to enhance security measures along these highways, IGP General Kale Kaihura says road diversions are to be created. Kaihura explains that those traveling will be able to reach their destination safely without having to stay long in traffic.
I've instructed the traffic police to create diversion, look for where we can divert traffic so that we reduce jams along the highways, especially like Jinja Kampala Highway. Those jams are a security risk. We call upon the members of the public to cooperate. There are a number of roads that traffic can be congested through diversion.
There will also be checkpoints along these roads so as to detect criminals.
We shall have to put checkpoints in place as again a way of detecting detecting any criminals that may want to cause problems in our country.
Ugandans have been advised to keep a neighborhood watch around their places of residence and places of work in this critical time.
This time again, As the vehicle for neighborhood watch, again it's also in the, this one should apply in all public places.
The Inspector General of Police has so far announced 2 terror alerts within a short period of time, which calls for vigilance among members of the public.
I must inform the country that we receive information from reliable sources that Al-Shabaab plans to attack a school, a college, or a university along the Kampala Jinja Highway. We've taken specific measures and we are coordinating closely with the authorities.
A strong terror warning on Uganda comes at a time when a university in Kenya was attacked by Al-Shabaab militants, killing over 140 students and leaving several others injured. Reporting for Urban TV, I'm Ruth Naseje.
All right, so Bobby, what is your take on road diversions in relation to terrorism in this scenario?
Well, anything that could be done to improve traffic, especially in this rainy season, would definitely be welcomed by me, because traffic is getting really, you know.
But every
definitely. Government is to set up a skills development authority as a measure to fast track efforts to confront the rising unemployment rates, especially among the youths. The private sector-led initiative will, however, demand for sustainable financing. Stakeholders are suggesting for the introduction of training levy for all businesses to address this challenge.
Government and the private sector have identified skills development as a key strategy to reduce poverty, enhance productivity, competitiveness, and employability. It is in this light that both the public and private sectors are teaming up to create the Skills Development Authority.
The Skills Development Authority exists in several countries already, both within Africa and beyond. And the Reform Task Force, which I chair, has got the task of implementing it, making sure that the Skills Development Authority is in place Our term is 2 years. If we can get it in place as of middle of next year or earlier, we shall have made a big impact on skills development in the country.
Under a 10-year program to cost over 2.1 trillion shillings, the focus will be on training the youth and children, including those who are out of school.
We raise quality by investing in instructors training, strengthening the BetaVet infrastructure. Those are the schools. Some of these technical schools, if you go to them, they are very run down. So we need to work and improve on them. And then introducing modern quality assurance systems.
The reform task force that is to oversee the establishment of the Skills Development Authority within the next 2 years suggests that employers can play a key role in funding the authority's activities if they agree to paying a training levy.
Funds allocated by government takes time to get, and it's always a challenge. You requisition money, you get it after some time. It's not effective. The employer is saying it should be a deductible expense. You know, when you do taxation, if it is acceptable as part of its deductible expense. I think the draft document has been sent on a training levy to the Ministry of Finance.
In most countries, strengthening the role of employers in all areas of skills development has been a critical success factor in improving systems that boost productivity and competitiveness. This has also enabled the youth to become more innovative, especially in adding value to locally sourced raw materials which were previously exported without being processed into consumables. Lubega Emmanuel reporting for Urban Television.
And what's your take on that?
That was good. I think that if we look at a skills development authority, this is much more important than government focusing on institutions like universities that majorly train theory work other than putting practical skills on the ground. So when we have a skills development authority, that means that our students or our children in the near future will be learning direct skills, something they can apply and stop looking for jobs, but rather would create some.
Does that suggest changing our syllabuses?
Definitely suggests changing our syllabuses, because our syllabuses have run all the way since the colonial times, and this is not the plan we have today. Times have changed, the days have changed, and we need to now focus on creating other than searching for them. Now, ahead of the budget approval process for the financial year 2015-2016, civil society is concerned that government is increasingly reducing allocations to key social services. According to the National Budget Framework, education, health and agriculture will receive less funding in the forthcoming financial year. We have more to that story.
In the 2014-2015 national budget, the health sector and the education sector were allocated 3 trillion shillings. But according to the National Budget Framework paper, for the coming financial year, this will be slashed by 10%. The civil society budget advocacy group says reducing of funds from these key social service sectors will directly affect the population.
By reducing money of this sector that have a direct impact on the population, not only will this affect the overall welfare of the population, but it will also increase economic cost of government take care of the sick, the illiterate, and also the hungry population.
The civil society is concerned as to why the public administration and interests on debts are being allocated more funds.
What we have realized is that the cuts that we have seen in government departments have really affected the key sectors like agriculture, education and health. And it has left out the bourgeoisie sectors. We call them bourgeoisie because these are luxury sectors like public administration and interest payment.
Ahmed Haji from the African Youth Development Link adds that there are more critical issues that need to be attended to. He points out that if the education sector loses more than 45 billion, children and the youth are further marginalized.
So we are raising a flag that why do you have to pay the RDCs and the deputies now? Because you're delivering an electoral budget. And we are trying to refocus government on some of those critical budget, critical issues at hand. Because if you don't invest in the health of the sector, it means that the young people will not get the next health services. The young mothers will die. And these are some of the critical issues.
The national budget proposal was presented to Parliament this week by State Minister of Finance for Privatization, Haston Kajara. Unlike previously, it has to be discussed and approved by May before the formal reading in June. Reporting for Urban TV, Ruth Naseje and Ruth Nachanzi.
Well, you are watching the Newsroom, and of course, this is TNR Celebrity Edition. My guest tonight is Bobi Wine. My name is Joshua Paul. Right now, let's go for a short break. But when you return, don't touch the dial because we have a lot in store for you.